Hello everyone, welcome in Cool IT Help. Guys, in this video tutorial, I will tell you how to set up Tomcat to support SSL or HTTPS. Yes, you guys can run your project on HTTPS on localhost. So guys, before starting, I have a request. If you think this video is useful for you, so please like this video and share with your friends as well. And if you want such more useful videos on my channel, so please subscribe my channel and press this notification bell icon so that you will get the latest video updates ASAP. Now we will start. So our agenda is we're going to set up the Tomcat to support the SSL or HTTPS. So here what we have to do, I have prepared a notes and all these steps mentioned in it. So I will go step by step. You guys can proceed with this video step by step, or you can just watch this video first and you can do it your own as well. So the first, we need some prerequisite. So in the prerequisite, in point one, we must have JDK installed our machine. Also, we must have set up Java underscore home environment variable in this setup. I hope you guys familiar with these two things, JDK installation and Java underscore home on your setup. So I'm going to check on my machine, is it Java underscore home available or not? Okay, so I'm here in the environment variable. So I'm checking here. So Java underscore home variable, the environment variable is set up properly and it's okay. So we are okay with the first requirement, prerequisite requirement, and the second one is Tomcat 8. So guys, you have to download Apache Tomcat 8.0 version or archive on your machine and just extract somewhere in a folder. So you will see such these required folders inside the Apache Tomcat folder. So here inside the bin, we have two files, startup.bat and shutdown.bat. I hope you guys familiar. Startup.bat is for starting your Tomcat server, or there's another file, shutdown.bat. So we can hit this file when we want to shut down our server. Okay, now going to the note file. So these two prerequisite is fine and we are okay with it. Now we're moving to the next. So in the next step, we have to open command prompt. Okay, so here I am going to open the command prompt. Okay, here's the command prompt. Okay, now here I have to run simple command. Okay, I am going to change the directory. I am reaching at the place where the JDK is installed. Okay, so I am pasting this thing. Oops, something is wrong. I think the copied text is pasted two times. So let me correct it. Okay, so this is the right one. Press enter and you will see. You are right now inside the JDK 1.8/bin folder. Okay, so here we're going to start. So the very first step, we have to generate a key store file. That means a file which has a .key store extension. Okay, so we're going to produce. So what we have to do, we have to run this tool and we will pass these parameters, and this command will generate .key store file on our system. Okay, so just copy that command. Now here I'm going to run on the command prompt. Okay, here we go. Okay, so in the first step, when you press enter, it will ask you a password. So guys, please note down this password. Okay, we need it in the second step. So we store this password separately somewhere. So we will use the same password in the next step. That means in step two. So I am giving a simple password, which is PASSWORD1. And again, it will ask you to re-enter the created password, PASSWORD1, and press enter. Then it will ask you for this some basic information like your first name and last name. So you can put XYZ at this place. What is your organizational unit? You can place any information, relevant information, what you want to enter. And what is the name of your organization? So right here, I'm writing it, Cool IT Help. And what is your city? You can put XYZ city, in which city you are living. That doesn't matter. You can place XYZ, any value here. And again, it will ask you for the state or province in which you are living. So you can give ABC. Press enter. Then it will ask you for the country code, two-digit country code. At the last, it will ask you for the all information is correct. So write yes and press enter. Okay, before proceeding, it will ask you the enter the password, PASSWORD1. Then press enter. Okay, then we have to enter the same password one more time. Okay, it's done now. So when you see the prompt and the file is generated on the C drive. So we have to go inside the C drive under the users and we will search for the key store file. Okay, so let me show you where the file is generated. So go to the C drive and go to the users folder and go here the username and here you can see .keystore file is generated successfully. Okay, now we're going back to our step. So we have done first step successfully. Okay, also we have stored the password which we have given in this step. So our password is PASSWORD1. Okay, that's all. Now we're going to step number two. So here is the second step. Guys, in this step, we have to configure Tomcat for using the keystore file and configuring -SSL configuration. Okay, to do this, what we have to do? We have to open the server.xml file, which is inside the Apache Tomcat folder. We will do some replacement inside that file. Okay, let me show you. Going inside the Apache Tomcat, go inside the bin. Sorry, we have to go inside the conf and here we will find server.xml. So let me open this file in the notepad. So here is our server.xml. Okay, so we have to find one tag, which is connector tag. Okay, so you can see this is the commented portion, define a SSL here. So this is the place where we have to place our text. So this is the connector tag. So we will replace that commented portion with this XML. Okay, so I'm copying this thing. I have given the same thing in the description box, so you guys can copy from that place and you can use it. Okay, once you copied this thing, okay, come here in the server.xml and just select this commented portion and paste it. Okay, so here, once you paste, you have to do two mandatory things. Okay, first one, we have to specify the path of the .keystore file that we have generated in the step one. Also, we have to give the keystore password that we have stored in the notepad. Okay, so these two things we have to modify at this place. Okay, so first we have to copy the path of the .keystore file. So I'm going to find out the path in the C drive, users, and this is my username. And inside we have .keystore file. So here it is. Okay, let me copy this path. Okay, path is copied. Now going back to our server.xml and in the double quotes, you have to replace. Okay, this way. Okay, so this is the path. We have keystore file inside users. and then the next folder is Amit, A-M-I-T-K, and then we have a keystore file. Because here backslash will not work, so we have to place forward slash. So I am replacing the backslash with the forward slash. So it's done. So our first thing, that specifying the keystore file path, is done. Now we have to place the password. So in the first step, we have generated the password, which is password 1. This is the same password that you have given in the first step. So the same password you have to update at this place. Okay, guys, once you're done, this is all set. Okay. Okay, now we will save this file and we will minimize it. Okay, now going back to our folder where we have our Apache Tomcat folder. So here it is. So we have done with the second step. Now we will launch the Tomcat and we will check, is it working or not? And I will explain the step third later. Okay, now we are inside. We are going to start our server. We have to go inside the bin folder. You can see there's a file starter.bat. Just double click on it and your server will start. Okay, so you can see such a black and white window and you can see lots of text is written inside, and that means your server is started. Now we will open the Chrome browser and we will type https://localhost:8443. Okay, once you click, you will see such page. Here you have to click on the advanced and just go downside, and there's a link proceed to localhost. Click on it. And it will take 2-3 seconds to connect the Tomcat. And you can see Apache Tomcat home page is loading right now. Here we go. So, wow, it's working. So you can see the Apache Tomcat home page is loading on the port 8443. That means our HTTPS services is running on 8443 port. So that's the way you can run your local host on HTTPS, or you can deploy your application in Tomcat and you can force your application to run on HTTPS. To do that, you have to change one setting in web.xml. You have to add a small piece of code .xml. So in the third step that I was going to explain, so this is the right time to explain. Once you're done with your Tomcat homepage is loaded with the HTTPS, then if you want to deploy your application and you want to run your application on HTTPS, then you have to copy this tag security constraint and place this inside the web.xml, inside your web.xml file, okay? And just save it and just redeploy your project and hit the localhost 8443/ your project folder. Then your web application will launch on HTTPS. I hope you guys found this video useful and all concept clear to you right now. If you have any doubts, so please comment. I will try my best. A request, if you think this video is useful, so please like, share and subscribe my channel and keep watching Cool IT Help for new upcoming videos.